at large, Warren and I, we never tried to make money out of stupidity of our dumb buyers. We tried to make money by buying. And if we were selling horseshit, we didn't want to pretend it was a cure for arthritis. And I think it's better to go through life our way instead of theirs. And I think it's always been this way. I think there's always been chicanery. Think of the carnival, so the carny operator. Think how much trickery there is in a carny operation. And people just seek out the weaknesses of their fellow man and take advantage. And you have to get wise enough so you avoid them all. And you can't avoid them if they're in your family. I have no solution to that. But where you have a fair choice, there's just so many people that should be avoided. My father had this best friend and client. And he also had this other client who was a big blowhard. And he was always working for the big blowhard, and he wasn't ever working for his wonderful client whom I admired. And I said, "Why do you do this?" And he said, "Charlie, you idiot." He says, "The big blowhard is an endless source of legal troubles. He's always in trouble, overreaching and misbehaving and so forth. Whereas Grant McFadden treats everybody right, the employees, the customers, everything. He gets involved with some psychotic, he walks over there and makes a graceful exit immediately. So a man like that doesn't need a lawyer." And my father was trying to teach me something, and it really worked. I spent my whole life trying to be like Grant McFadden. And I want to tell you, it works. It really works. Peter Hoffman is always telling me, if the crooks only knew how much money you could make by being honest, they'd all behave differently. Warren has a wonderful saying I like. He says, "You take the high road, it's never crowded." And it's worked. Take the Daily Journal Corporation. We made quite a few millions of dollars out of the foreclosure boom because we published legal notices and we dominated the publication of foreclosure notices in the worst real estate depression in the history of modern times. And we could have raised our prices at the time and made more tens of millions of dollars, but we didn't do it. You know, when your fellow citizens are losing their damn houses in the worst recession, Charlie Munger, billionaire, raises prices. It would look lousy on the front page of the paper for people around the office. Should you do it? And the answer is no, of course not. Maybe when you're, Warren always said it's probably always a mistake to marry for money, and it's really stupid if you're already rich. And it's really stupid when you're already rich to get a reputation of being a total no good.